Wow. You and your family sleep?
The door spoiled. That's after the death of my wife.
Oh. The she's wife late. Is dead?
She's late. She's not yet buried. Still in the mortuary. It's because of the financial that makes me not to bury the woman. It has been taking a long time now. If not 2 years.
2 years?
Yes. He died on October.
So when I go to that place, they ask me to pay the some amount. So after paying the money, it was drip that they gave her. The drip did not reach even half, around 3, 10 after 3. In the afternoon, she gave up.
And even that people can be this kind of... Never knew that people can be in this kind of situation in Lagos, Lagos State.
Weeks ago, I got a video on my DM about this family by a gentleman. Usually I get videos like that every time, but when I saw this one, I was compelled and moved by the situation the family was in. And I knew I had to do something about it.
All these sugar stations, they don't suffer, they don't drink in the morning, afternoon, evening, night. Any morning, hey, they will sleep, but they will enter from God. They cry every day. Every day, the mama don't say anything. Very fast, every day. The way they open.
So I had to plan my trip, because I wasn't even in Nigeria when I saw the video. I had to plan my trip down to Nigeria, and I met the man. He's a widower. His wife died 3 years ago, and he hasn't buried the woman because he doesn't have money to do that. And he's living in a place where I don't have words to describe how that place is.
And if it rains, rain will enter here.
Even the one that felt
yes,
this place was full of.
So, when rain is falling on your children, what do you do?
Well, we used to carry them go outside.
What of in the midnight?
In the midnight, so like outside on those motor, we do sleep inside the motor. Maybe after
you sleep inside the car.
So after the water dryer, so we come on.
So I knew we had to do something, so immediately we set out to get them an apartment. And we have furnished it, completely furnished. Food stuff that will last them for a very long time, then some funds, and most especially money for him to go and bury his wife. You know, we are still trying to figure out what he can do. Business he's very good at, so I told him to go and bury his wife. When he comes back, you know, we can now, you know, get him a business, you know, see what we can put him on. And already I've told them to go and start looking for school for the kids, so that they will be in school. You know, I'm very happy now that they have a good home and they have a bed to sleep on. Now I can go home and I will sleep very well on my own bed, because I couldn't sleep on my bed when I saw them. I want to thank each and every one of you that showed your concern and that that supported immensely. A lot of my friends, I can't even begin to mention, Kefiano Otters, a lot of you came by and, you know, showed massive support. So I want to appreciate you guys. You guys don't know what you've done, you know, by just showing support. It makes me know that what I'm doing is not, I'm not crazy, because sometimes people think I'm crazy.
This way, God Almighty, the royal family of God.
Amen.
And sometimes people think I'm very rich when I do these things, but I believe the reason why God gave us what He has given us is so that we can take the little from there and help other people. Because people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And the essence of life is actually to help other people live their life. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is what Jesus Christ came on earth to talk about, where He said you need to help the poor, you need to help the needy. This is where you find fulfillment. This is where you find happiness. And for me, if it means me emptying my whole account to do this, I'll do it over and over and over again, knowing that it's a boy's future is secured, you know, and the family is happy.
This is your new house. So everything here.
So this is your new home.
Everything here.
Now I got from beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place.
So when rain is falling now, you don't have to be scared where you sleep or go inside the bus. Or go inside the bus. Like I said, what is more important than for you to go home? Let your wife rest, final rest. So I don't know when you want to go home, but take this money.
But you have chosen to call me your own.
This young man was the person that sent me the video, and I want to thank you for sending that video. And I want to thank God for me to see that video, because my DM can be crazy, you know.
I was surprised.
Yes, you guys are doing a great job.
Thank you very much.
And I will see as much as I can, you know, to see how we can do more stuff.
Okay,
you
no
know
problem.
So well done. There are a whole lot of things I will still do with you.
Thank you very
you
know much.
So thank you to every one of you, and yes, I'm happy I can go home now.
Gonna break these chains around me. Gonna learn to fly again. Maybe hard, but I'll do it. When I'm back on my feet again, soon these tears will all be drying. Soon these eyes will see the sun. Might take time, but I'll see it.
It's because of the financial that makes me not to bury the woman. I've been taking a long time.
When I'm back on my feet again, I won't crawl down the street again. And they'll look at me again. They'll see that I'm strong. Oh, gonna hear children laughing. Gonna hear the voice of sin. Won't be long till I hear them. When I'm back on my feet again.
I'm very excited. One family is off the streets, and they are like what? A million more to go. So we'll keep pressing. We'll keep getting them off the street, because at the end of the day, it's what we should do. And I'm challenging each and every one of you to do the same. This is the essence of the Give Challenge. The Give Challenge is to challenge you to help people around you. Imagine if we begin to help people around us, we will not have the Nigeria we are crying about now. We'll have a better Nigeria. So most times the problem is not only from the government, but it's from ourselves. So let us realize that there is still a lot of work to do. And I'm not going to sleep until we see the Nigeria we desire and we get these people off the streets and put them in a good house.
I'll be back on my feet again.